Okay, here comes Don, and he'll mute everybody, so it'll clean up a lot and get rid of the background noise.
Yes, I am. I am here. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to mute the line. Right there. Okay. Welcome to the call, everyone. This call is going to be very interesting for you. As the text had stated, tonight is a call that gives everyone here on the line the opportunity to go back 10 years. I mean, if you think about that, if you could go back 10 years in your life, I mean, what would you do differently? I know for me, I do a lot of things differently. And I've done some things that were correct. I mean, life really, you know, it's not about winning them all. It's just about winning more than you lose. I used to have this analogy, my God, I don't know, years back. And I'd say, you know, I'm not looking to make every correct decision. I'm just looking to make more of them than wrong decisions. Life's about moving 3 steps forward. Maybe you take 2 steps back. Maybe you take another step back. But then 4 leaps forward, 2 steps back, 5 leaps forward, 3 steps back. And as long as you're always ahead, you end up eventually where you want to be. Because that's what happened with me. And I think that's the case, say, if you're in the stock market. You know, you just got to win more than you lose. Or I know in venture capitalists, venture VCs, their business model is they'll invest into 10 companies and 9 of them will lose. But it's that one winner, that whale, that pays for the whole show. And so for me, I've operated my life that way, and it's worked out so far. My first couple of companies I did were network marketing companies, and me being more of an introvert, I get excited over stuff, but sometimes maybe too overexcited at that age that I was when I started. No one took me seriously, and it was just a raging failure. And I got out of that and said, I'll never do any kind of income opportunity again or business, and went into direct sales for a while, got burnt out on that. That's a hard road to hoe. And eventually, after doing an eBay business that basically burnt me out to the level where I was willing to collect shopping carts at the grocery store, I answered an ad in a newspaper for a job. I heard someone introducing themselves on the call. I said, hey, I'm just looking for a job. Yeah, I was looking for a job too. And, you know, called ads in the newspaper, and one of the ads I called was for an opportunity. Now, I knew once the guy invited me to a live call, I knew right away what it was. I knew it was an income opportunity because only income opportunities invite you to a live call. So I told the guy, I said, listen, just, I know what this is. Just tell me about it. What's the product? What, you know, tell me a little bit. And he wouldn't. He's like, listen, you can either go to the call or not go to the call. And me being as desperate as I was willing to look at everything. I think you have to. You know, beggars can't be choosers. I was not in a place where I could say no to things. I just wasn't. So as much as my ego wanted to prevail at that point, I had to humble myself and say, you know what, I'm not too good for anything right now, so I will go and I will listen to this call. And I did. And the opportunity that I listened to was $1,500. Now, I didn't have $1,500. They were about to turn off my electric. I didn't have any money. However, I saw opportunity. I saw something that I believed I could do. I called up my younger brother right after the call. Well, actually, the guy three-wayed me after the call. That's the process they had. They do a three-way. And the guy asked me, are you in or are you out? And I said, I'm in. He's like, okay, great. You're going to FedEx me a check for $1,500 and you can get started. And I'm like, all right, I'll send it out to you tomorrow. No, I didn't have $1,500. Okay. But I knew I could get it, right? Life isn't about having resources. It's about being resourceful. You know, if it was about having resources, then being resourceful wouldn't be a thing. Like no one would ever say that. Like no one would ever say you have to be resourceful because everyone would have resources. You know, because if you think about it, that's what life is. You know, why is life so challenging? You know, think about it. You ever think about it? I think about shit like that. I'm like, why is it so challenging? It must be for a reason. It certainly isn't to bow down. It certainly isn't, I know for sure, and I think everyone here on this call will agree, even if we don't like them, even if we bitch and complain, we know when we're faced with a challenge, it's meant for us to overcome. Or it wouldn't be given to us. Because you'll notice in life, everyone has their own challenges. Everyone has one, and I don't care what age you're at, you've got one, and that's your next step in life. It's meant for you. Now you can bow down and back away, and life will eliminate you, right? That's what it does. It does it in the wild. It does it in every aspect of life. If you're not willing to overcome the challenge, life will figure out a way to just void you, okay? Because we're here to evolve. So I figured out a way to get the money, called my younger brother. I borrowed it. I sent the guy a check. For the first month, I struggled. And this, I said, you know what? This reminds me of those three opportunities that I did that didn't work. Here I am back again. I swore I'd never do one of these things again, and here I am back in it because I'm desperate and wasn't making any money. And I remember getting on my knees in my basement because that's where my office was. My office, my little home, little office was set up in the basement. And I got on my knees and I prayed. So maybe that will help you if you're in a situation like I was. Get on your knees and pray. Just say, please. And I tell you what, it worked because the next 3 weeks after that, I made 14 sales back to back to back to back, one after another. It was a miracle, to be honest with you. And maybe it was just my resolve. Maybe it was because I just spent 6 weeks and I didn't give up and I kept fighting and I was putting in all day long. You know, I was putting in the time. I wasn't just, well, I hope this works. If you ask the question, I hope this works, then you don't have a chance in the world because you don't know what you're doing. You need to know what the step is you need to take in order to progress. And I knew what that was. It just wasn't working for me. So after 6 weeks of doing that, I finally had my break. And I made $14,000 in the next couple of weeks. And that began my new career in the home business income opportunity space. And I've not looked back since. And my income has grown year after year after year. I've had some setbacks in between things. Okay, sometimes you take things for granted. But luckily, each and every day, I've got another opportunity to get back up on my feet and keep looking for that next opportunity to reveal itself to me so that I can take advantage of it. And so this opportunity here that is being presented to all of us is one of those things. You know, I love to pick the big things because what I have found in my life is that I'm a worker. I'm going to put in the time. I'm going to put in 15 hours a day, no matter what it is that I'm doing. And so I want to pick the thing that's actually going to be correct for me. I'm not going to want to do something that's going to pay me a little amount of money. I had a wrong idea in my head when I was younger, and I got this from network marketing. This is, you know, there's these things that people say, these quotes, and they sound good, like it's better to have had, like it's better to have loved and lost than to have never have loved at all. Yeah, try it. I don't think so. Ignorance is bliss. It's better to have never loved than to have lost. It's horrible. It's better to have never had than to have lost. Okay, so the saying that it's easier to get a dollar from a million people than it is to get $1 million from one person was something that made sense to me. I said, yeah, it's easy to get a dollar from a million people. Okay, however, what you don't get until you try it is by the time you get to the 100th person, you're probably dead because the work that's involved in doing that is very time consuming and you burn out. You lose your mojo, you lose your spirit, you lose your desire, and next thing you know, you're curled up on the couch in a ball in depression, overcome by cortisol from all the work you're putting in and the rejection, because not everyone's going to give you a dollar, okay? Okay, and so what I've learned in life through a different experience, and it happened to be through a relationship that I had with someone that taught me economy of scale. He said, Don, you're incorrect. I don't know where you got that bullshit from, but I can tell you this. and I'm look at these checks that I have here. He says, it's easier to get $1 million from one person than it is to get a dollar from 1 million people. As a matter of fact, I had a friend even before that that kind of gave me a visual that I didn't really, you know, connect the dots to, but I did understand that this kid was playing golf all day. He hardly ever worked, but he was much, you know, doing much better than I was financially, and he was selling spools of steel. So, you know, when there was a company that was wanted to make anything in metal, spoons or anything, then what ended up happening was they would buy it from him. And so he only had to sell a couple of deals a year to live the life that he wanted to live. And I'm out there grinding every single day. Just the difference in energy, the difference in confidence, the difference in everything that this guy had compared to me was substantial. So I just, you know, kind of passed that by until that next experience where the guy said, listen, economy of scale, it's easier to get $1 million from one person than it is from, you know, $1 from 1 million people. So when I was faced with that opportunity of $1,500, what really caught my attention was that they had a second and third level product that totaled $20,000. And I said, well, you know, I'm going to be talking to people all day long. I could make $10 from each of those. And if I signed up 10 people, I'd make $100. Or I could talk to 10 people. And if I only signed up one, at that time, that commission was $13,000. That one sale not only would help me financially, and it would buy me some time. I could do some advertising. I could also, you know, operate from a level of confidence. I no longer need the money. I'm no longer worrying about bills and things like this. I don't have the pressure or the stress. Okay, it would just put me in a much greater space, and it did. It did. And within 4 months of that, I was making $25,000 a month. My wife at the time was an attorney. She retired from her career. Like, who wants to do that shit, right? Really negative. She couldn't wait to get out of that. At the same time, I remember her telling me, Don, when are you going to stop chasing these little dream little businesses that you're chasing? And she was not supportive of me at all until I made it. She was like, oh, I believed in you the whole time. I was like, no, you didn't. You told me to get a job making $300 a week so you wouldn't go crazy. You didn't believe in me or anything I was doing. So don't tell me that. Like, no, I didn't. You know, but no one, you know, people have selective memory, I guess. But I remember it because it hurt. Okay. But I believed that, you know, if I kept moving forward, I'd become something in my life. It was important for me to become something in my life. It was important for me to be at a place where I was financially stable. It was. And I knew it was possible because other people were doing it. I'm in the same world they are in, and I have access to the same information, the same opportunities that everyone else does. I just had to learn or figure out what it was that they had or what they were doing or what business they were in that, you know, they were having that success. That's all I had to do. We can do that. Anyone can do that. I certainly could. So that opportunity changed my life. And once I got a taste for that success, the next one, my income went up by 1,000%. And I didn't change. I didn't learn anything new. It's just the opportunity itself. My income went up by 1,000%. So I've really learned that economy of scale. I've learned that, you know, you've got to find these big ones because you're going to put in the work. You're going to put in the time. You're going to put in the sacrifice. You're going to go through the pain, all the challenges, all the doubt, all the rejection. The people that are going to be the ones that are telling you, you know, why you're doing these things. I mean, that's going to be there no matter what it is. So you might as well win big when you win. Because the amount of money that you make when you win big changes you. None of the information I've learned, none of the books I've read, which hasn't been many actually, okay, because there's nothing that I can learn from anyone else's experience. The only experience I'm interested in is the experience that I'm having while I'm doing it. That's the only thing that can provide me any value. Give me some direction, point me in the way to do it, show me the company, show me someone else that's doing it, and I will mimic them and I will eventually have that success. If I put in the time each and every day and I'm consistent, I will have that success. And I did over and over again. Now, we've been developing our new software because you know what? I don't want to miss out on opportunities. You know, when I talk about if I could do the last 10 years of my life over, even though I've done well financially, I've missed out on a lot of opportunities. Even though I was doing really well in what I was doing, some of the ones that I missed out on were even greater. It'd be like I was working a job, putting in 80 hours a week at Circle K, and I was just too busy to look at another opportunity. Even though, let's say, you know, IBM was going to hire me. I don't have time. I'm too busy worrying about paying the bills. I'm too worried about surviving. I'm too worried about what's going on in my life, my current agenda, to look at anything else. So whether you're making $15 an hour or $15,000 an hour, it doesn't really matter. Whatever you're doing has your focus completely locked. So you kind of pass up on those opportunities, and I did, some big ones. I, you know, would actually be a billionaire standing here today. Two opportunities I passed up had I taken advantage, even though I was making millions. It wasn't, you know what I mean? I mean, I'm using the Circle K analogy, but I was doing well. But I tell you what, the difference between $1 million and $1 billion is very, very great. It only takes 6 months earning $5,000 a day to make $1 million. That's it. It's not a lot of money. It sounds like a lot if you don't have it. I remember when I was a kid, you know, 20 or 22 years old, that if I had $1,000, $1,000 would change my life. I remember saying that. If I just had $1,000, my life would be changed. I remember that. But $1 million at that time seemed like a lot, but it's really not. Because I've been in positions where $1 million wouldn't even have any effect on my life, because just I'm at a different level. It doesn't go as far. But even though I was making that kind of money, it's just like being in the Circle K and missing a greater opportunity, is that I missed out on billion-dollar opportunities that I'd be standing here a billionaire today, which would mean the equivalent of $5,000 a day for 6 months versus $1 billion, which is $5,000 a day for 360 years. 360 years versus 6 months. See the difference? It's a big difference. And I missed out on those opportunities. And I want to make up for them. And I've been on the hunt, on the lookout. I've got a system. So I'm getting hit with all kinds of things all the time. And I look at them and I say, you know what? That's the same thing that, you know, the other person, you know, hit me with last week. It's just a different product, same packaging. I said, you know what? I think you guys are reading the same script. They're like, no, this is the best thing ever. And the other person said, I said, that's what the other person said. No, this is new. That's what the other person said. I said, you guys reading the same script, I should put you guys on the phone together and let you battle it out. It'd be good entertainment, actually. But I can tell you, it's the same damn product, the same opportunity. It's just different packaging. To wait for something that's truly new, I haven't seen it in a long, long time, over a decade. They don't come very often. Cryptocurrency. This opportunity, you know, revolves around cryptocurrency. How many times in your lifetime has the world transitioned its currency? If you're in the U.S. or whatever country, you know, you're in Europe, the euro. If you're in the U.S., it's the USD. I mean, when I was born, we were using USD, and we're still using USD. However, the world is converting into digital currency, and they're doing it rapidly. And that's going to happen in our lifetime. We will see the whole world on a digital currency, revenue stream, right? The whole world will be on digital currency, right? So that's happening now. That's once in a lifetime. Once in a lifetime. And we get a chance to be involved in it. Now, I can tell you that it's complicated to get involved in that. It is. It's even beyond my ability to, I mean, I don't want to work that hard. I'm not a stock market person, because I'm not the type of person that wants to chase forever. That's why I like residual income. You get to take a break. You get to breathe. You get to work on yourself. You get to enjoy life. I just see, like, the stock market is just a never-ending, from my mind, I would never be able to rest. I don't really like that. But the opportunity that's launching, that is launching through this system here, is an opportunity that lets you get involved in that without you having to do it. Without you having to do it. And for me personally, and I don't know what you have to make up for or what you love to make up for, if you could go back 10 years, what things you would have taken advantage of, what opportunities would you have not let pass you by, what different decisions you would have made. But I know for me personally, missing out on two opportunities that would have made me a billionaire standing here right now today, this one is the one that gets me there. This is the makeup for me. So unless you missed out on something bigger than that, I would imagine and I suggest that this is the opportunity for you as well. Because what is happening in the crypto space as it is, you can become a billionaire. But you've got to put in the time, you've got to put in the work. It can be a year plus to learn everything you need to, you know, to learn in this space. All the graphs and charts and trends and, you know, what's going on, just the whole language of it. Where you've got a company that's launched that is actually doing it for us. They're doing it for us. There's nothing we have to learn. Now, I mentioned this last week with the Pacesetter bonus that this company has going on. And if you think about it, a stockbroker gets 1%. That's it, 1%. If you ever see the movie Wolf of Wall Street, right? They get 1%, and these guys become millionaires. You got Ferraris. They're rich. They're millionaires. 1%, and they've got to sell their own stock. Where with this company, Daisy, you don't got to do any of that. You don't got to sell stock. You don't got to go and, you know, cold call people to get them to invest with you. All you have to do is get positioned in the fund. And that fund is $500 million. They've already contributed to the fund $27 million in 4 days of a test launch, I guess you could call it. And they're about to launch here again the next couple days. And that fund will go to $500 million relatively quickly. I imagine they'll hit it in the first month. Second month, tops. If they hit it in 1 week, I wouldn't be surprised. Or I would be impressed. 2 weeks, I wouldn't be completely shocked. I'd be like, wow, that's great. But I wouldn't be completely shocked. Because what's cycling through the crypto space is billions of dollars daily. So it's really not a big accomplishment, $500 million in 2 weeks, for something that is already shown to be very popular. It's the ground is fertile with this. So that puts you in a position to earn not 1%, but almost 2%, 1.8%. And all you have to do is refer 24 people. That's it. Now, you can, you know, like any other opportunity, recruit, refer others, make your 10% whatever commission off the referrals of others, and that's great and all that. And if Daisy, and if that's all that it produced and provided, that's still a great opportunity because it's fertile ground. People have said yes to this. 50,000 people, 53,000 people in four days said yes to it. You wouldn't say no to something like that. You just wouldn't. What are you going to do? Go into an opportunity that maybe 2,000-3,000 people signed up? I can tell you that the company I was in that I built – well, not built, purchased my first million-dollar home, put my kids in private school, bought everything I wanted, only had 10,000 people in it for 4 years. I mean, that's the cap. Another one that I launched that was making me millions per month capped out about the same thing, about 10,000 people. The market has grown since then, so, you know, things have changed. I know Ripplin put in 1 million people in 30 days. That's never happened. I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with Empower Network. They were the first to really kind of take it to another level. I mean, they put 300,000 people in. Like, that really was an eye-opener on how big the market is growing, the home business, you know, income opportunity market. I mean, there it is. The numbers don't lie. People are looking for opportunity. But to put 53,000 people in 4 days, I mean, it's like the writing's on the wall. You know, it's like the guy who's stuck on the roof and the flood's coming and he's praying to God, hey, God, help me, please, please. And, you know, someone pulls up with a boat. He says, hey, get in the boat. I'll save you. And the guy's like, no, I'm good. God's got me. And then, you know, a helicopter comes. He's like, you know, climb on the ladder. We'll pull you to safety. And the guy's like, no, I'm good. God's got me. And then the guy drowns. And the guys go like, oh, what the hell, God? Why don't you help me? He's like, well, I sent you a boat and I sent you a helicopter. You didn't get on it. What can I do? What do you want me to do? You know, what does it take for you to see that this is the opportunity for you? What, like, what more do you need? What do you need? 53,000 people in 4 days. What more do you need? That's not happened before. It's not happened before. So we know it's fertile ground. We know you can make money just by referring it and doing that whole model there, because what you're making isn't just, you know, the fact that you're making money by recruiting people and getting a piece of what they, you know, contribute to this program, is that you're now taking your money and it's actually earning for you at the same time. So now it's like two of you. There's you and your money, both working all day long, making you money. It's like you've got a partner, but your partner is a financial person. There's you working, but then there's a financial person that's taking the money that you're making and making it grow. What else do you need to know, right? However, if you were so bold enough and ambitious enough and wish to gain that 10 years back that you've lost or missed opportunity, where you would have put you in a completely different world, the world that others may have taken, you know, advantage of those opportunities who are there now. You know, when Apple started, there was one of the guys, it's actually, you can look him up on, his name is Ronald. And he was one of the, he's one of the guys on Apple. When they signed that contract, that partnership contract, it was Steve Jobs, Wozniak, and this guy Ronald. And it's on there. You can see all three signatures. They started Apple Computer together. Well, Ronald sold his stock for $800 or something like that. And I believe, I forget, it's been a while since I looked at it, but I believe that it's worth like, it's worth like billions today. You know what I mean? Like he missed out on opportunity. And so that's what I mean. Like the people that have taken advantage of those opportunities that are now in a different place financially versus where, you know, some of you are, where you didn't. You got into comfort. You wanted to stay in your comfort zone. You wanted to do what was comfortable. Even though the things that are comfortable for you haven't served you. You know, I seen a thing on TikTok today that said that. It says, beware of the things that you've done that will continue to show up for you that are comfortable, that haven't paid off for you in the past. So this opportunity, Daisy, allows you to start over again. Allows me to start over again on those opportunities that I've missed. Within the crypto space, that's where it's going to happen. There's only really a couple ways to become a billionaire. Stock market. Like Bill Gates did not become wealthy from selling software. I've made a lot of money in software. And so hasn't Bill Gates. But where Bill Gates made his money from, and every other one, Mark Zuckerberg's worth $111 billion, all these guys, all these billionaires, they made money from stock. 80% of Bill Gates' wealth came from stock outside of Microsoft. You know, I mean, there it is. Stock. There's very few things you can do to become a billionaire. And cryptocurrency is greater than the stock. It's more volatile. There's more money in it. It's new opportunity. It's not saturated yet. You can be a fumbling idiot, just be focused on it, and actually become very wealthy in it. You don't have to be the best. Later, you'll have to be the best. Right now, you don't have to be the best. You can be a moron and make money in it. However, on top of that, you've got a company like Daisy that is, you know, when it comes to the AI trading, Dr. Anna is the innovator in the space. Everyone follows her. And that money is going to be traded not by some just partner, some financial guy that you've hired, but a professional organization that does the trading for institutional organizations, trading houses, enterprise level stuff. you know, trust her with their with millions of dollars, hundreds of millions. Trust her. And this is now open and available to us once in a lifetime. Once in a lifetime. And if you were to refer, put your head to the grindstone and refer 24 people in 30 days, you get 1.8% paid daily of that $500 million fund. And if you have three people that refer 24 people, then you get another 1.8% percentage of that fund. Think about it, 24 people. If you're going to do business opportunity, if you're going to get a job maybe in sales and sign up 24 clients or sell 24 toasters or sell 24 home security systems or you know, satellite systems or solar systems, I mean, you know, where are you going to be after your 24th customer? You're going to be having to sell another one. You're only as good as your last sale, right? Well, if you get into network marketing, you're going to have to sign up 24 people somewhere. Eventually, you're going to have to do it. But if you do it here, your recruiting efforts afterwards don't matter. Nothing matters after that. It's like you can finally breathe. And the money you'll be making after that is more than you've – and it's happened for me. The mind can certainly achieve more than it conceived. I've never – believed I would have made the amount of money that I've made. Never in a million years. And it still happened. It still happened. When the opportunity is great enough, you really can't, like, mess it up. You can't sabotage it because it's the opportunity, not you. If the opportunity isn't that good, then you better be good at what you do. You better be really good at what you do. But when the opportunity is great, then you can be half-assing it. And you make a lot of money, and your confidence goes up. Yeah, you think you're the badass, you think you're a rock star now, but you're not. You're just the same poor, you know, schmuck you were when you started, but you're rich now, and everyone looks at you differently. Everyone treats you differently, and because everyone looks at you differently and treats you differently, you do show up differently. You now have you have pep in your step. You do. You know, I was a poor kid on welfare. I don't feel it. I don't feel it because that's not how everyone sees me. I can even tell them that. I tell you that. You're not going to see me as I'm not that. I was just, you know, being that at the time, at, you know, that time in my life. When your income goes up, you show up differently. Your confidence goes up. And life is all about confidence, not skill. I'll take a confident person and put them against a skillful person any day of the week. If that person doesn't have great confidence, the confidence person will always win. Obviously, if you got skill, you know, you're going to have some confidence, but confidence overrides skill. It is really confidence. You started a job when we were kids, you know, we worked for like $10 an hour. Why do we work at $10 an hour? Because that's the only level of confidence we have. We only believe someone would pay us that much. But then once you've made it a while, you're comfortable with it. You say, I could do better than this. Now you're getting a job, maybe $18 an hour and $20 an hour. Next thing you know, you know, making $100,000 a year. It's all confidence. How do you know? Because if any of you went to college or have kids that went to college, most people that went to college aren't actually doing for a living what they got their degree in. So the knowledge that they received has nothing to do with how much money they're making. A college degree does give you confidence, though. So any confidence you can get, I mean, it helps, but it is confidence. And nothing changes your confidence more than making a lot of money. Nothing. I don't care how many trophies you've got. None of that stuff. Money changes your confidence. People seeing you differently changes your confidence. You start to believe them. They actually said that. I went through a thing called landmark education. They said, you know, really, you're just who people see you as. So if people see you as a shit bum, you actually show up that way. You never outperform how people see you. So it's important that people see you a certain way if you want to feel a certain way, because you'll start to believe it. You'll start to feel that way. You'll feel power. You'll feel strength. You'll feel like you know it all, because you'll believe everybody else. And what gets them to believe that is how much, you know, success you're having, how much money you're making. And that's it. This is your next challenge. You want to know your life path? Just look down. You're on it. You're here tonight. millions of people, billions of people don't know what's happening is happening. Billions. You do. You do. And you're here tonight. You're looking for an opportunity. There's no question, or you wouldn't have showed up. One guy's looking for a job, but so was I. And I decided with an opportunity instead of a job. I knew where a job led me. It led me right back to what made me, you know, in that position in the first place. Never making enough money to get ahead. Never. They're not designed to. Jobs are designed to keep you showing up every week. So they're going to pay you enough. Make sure that happens. That's it. So that's what I want to share with you guys. Obviously, everyone here has come through the system. Amazing. And you've seen the opportunity. They're going to be launching here in the next couple days, and they're going to go live. And you want to prepare. It's like making dinner. Where's most of the work when you're making dinner? Going to the grocery store? Like, who wants to go to the grocery store? I don't. I like, sometimes I'll just, like, eat like whatever I can pull out of the cupboard because I just don't want to go to the grocery store, right? So, I mean, it's a lot of work. Then you got to prep the stuff. You got to make the stuff. Right? 30 minutes prepping that, unless you just throw it in a, you know, beefaroni. I love beefaroni. I eat that a lot, actually, because it's convenient. Throw it in the microwave. But that's as far as I'm going to go. But you got to prep cook all that stuff. It takes the most amount of time. And then you sit and you eat, and what? You've ate your dinner in 15 minutes. But all that work just to get to that point. So understand that the work is in the prep. How prepared, you know, the word prepared means something. If it wasn't important, it wouldn't be a word. It wouldn't be necessary. It wouldn't be a thing. Prepared, how prepared are you? Are you set up? Have you gone through the learning curve that has to happen to start, you know, placing your link out there online? Do you even have a link yet? Have you watched the setup videos in the system? No, that's going to take time. You want to come from a place of being of readiness, being prepared. If you're going to go into war, would you say, "Hey, we'll prepare the army in the morning, right before the battle," or do you prepare the day before? Well, it depends on how smart you are. Do you want to win or do you want to get slaughtered? You want to win, so you're going to prepare. So right now, you have an opportunity to prepare. To be ready for battle. So when this goes live, you're ahead of everyone. You know, what do they say in marketing? What do they say? Coaches, and they always talk about this. If you know 5 minutes more information than the next person, you're now, you know, the leader in the space. You're the expert. You know, all you got to do is know 5% more than the next person, and you're the expert. That's all it takes, 5%, right? Do you know a placebo only has to outperform for a pharmaceutical company to get their whatever medication approved by the FDA? It only has to outperform a placebo by 5%. That's it. Like, that's it. 5% more than a sugar pill and we'll approve you. So you only have to be 5% more ready than the next person, and you're the expert. And getting started right now gives you the opportunity to do that. So just be 5% ready. You want to stack the deck in your favor in life as much as you can. As much as you can. It becomes easy. I wish I would have learned this later in life, but I didn't. I mean, earlier in life, I didn't. I learned it later. Rich, if your parents were rich, they told you this shit. Mine weren't. So I didn't learn this. Luckily, I surrounded myself with successful people and told me this stuff. Be prepared. Things like that. Economy of scale. Because no one told me that stuff. It's why rich kids are rich, because their parents are rich. They pass this stuff on to them. If you were raised in a trailer park, most likely you're still in that trailer park, right? How do trailer parks still exist? Because the kids are brought up in the trailer park. They're comfortable with it, and that's all they know. That's their whole world. They couldn't imagine going outside of that. I know I couldn't. Luckily, I got around different people that showed me a different world. And I believed... I now have some confidence that I could actually go for it. And even after 3 failed attempts with network marketing companies, I still believed it. You know, I mean, that would have taken me out, but it was the environment. You absolutely want to be in the right environment. And this is an environment of prosperity. Being around us, you know, it's just going to, you know, it's going to expose you to that thinking, because it is thinking. if you haven't gotten started already with Daisy, then you know there is some dysfunctional thinking there. There's some lack thinking, and that just needs to be washed out. You need to be brainwashed. You have that cleaned up, and it can happen because it happened for me. And it wasn't because of skill; it was because of new thinking. Getting rid of the it's easier to get a dollar from a million people. I mean, even still, that sounds good, but I know it's not true. It's not. It's not, because I tried that with 3 failed attempts, and it didn't work. Got involved in a high ticket, and that one commission gave me the confidence to make another one, to make another one, to make another one, to the extent where I'm making $85,000 profit in a single week. Like, what the hell? You know, but it was all confidence. I didn't get any better at what I was doing. I sucked up until I made my first sale. Sucked, completely sucked. Because I still lacked the confidence. I didn't, you know, like... But I hung around for 6 weeks, and I guess they kind of, you know, it wore off on me, because by week 6, made 14 sales at $1,000 commission, one after another, which led to all the success that I've had afterwards. So really being in that environment is everything. So that's really the conversation that I wanted to have with you guys. You do have an opportunity to make up for the previous 10 years. And I tell you what, when you do make it, you do forget all of that. You think, well, you know, I'll still have that baggage in the back. No, you won't. It'll be gone. It's like a faded dream. You ever have a nightmare, wake up, and you're spooked by it? But then after a week, you can't even remember it. Or even, like, during a day, it's like it just fades away. Like, it does become like this dream. You can't even, like, for certain, like, for sure, like, was that really my life? It doesn't even sound right. You forget about it, and you will forget about it. But if you don't change it, you will continue to live it. You have to let it go. You can't hold on to it. You have to let it go. And the only thing that is going to do that, unfortunately, I wish life was different. I didn't make it. Someone else did. We can have that conversation later with that person, right? But we do know it is the way that it is, and you or I are not going to be able to change our lives alone. We're going to require someone or something to do it for us. Environment, opportunity. This is the right environment. We are actually going to be going for our own coin with our system. We've been in development. I mean, we've had the system in different phases. One company at a time is all this system ever did. I didn't need to take on any more than that. And then we spent the last 4+ years, well, kind of a little over that, working on an open platform, and we're going to be going for our own coin. So the opportunity that we're involved in here with Daisy is the bridge to that. We're going to be learning this opportunity. Everything, I mean, you're going to be making lots of money in cryptocurrency. You're going to be learning some stuff. In a year from now, you're going to have people coming up to you just begging for 5 minutes of your time. Man, you won't even need to know it all, but the information that you'll know is going to be so much greater than theirs. You're going to sound like a genius. A genius. But all that knowledge that you're going to be acquiring while you're making money here goes into what's coming next in the crypto space. This thing's evolving. You know, they're starting to do these NFTs. They're tokenizing everything, artists, anything with an asset. Video games, the little swords and guns and weapons, they're, you know, tokenizing that because there's an asset. Anything that's an asset. Your lamp, you'll be able to tokenize your lamp. Your lamp now can be tokenized and put on the blockchain. Everything. So we're going to be doing our own coin, and our asset is leads. I've been talking about that, those that have been in the system for years. It's an asset. I did a video on it, matter of fact. I mean, we've got an asset. It's worth something. A lot of the NFTs that are launching don't really have anything but a project. We've got already the asset in place. And you'll be ahead of the game. You'll be part of that. You'll be part of our system. You'll be part of our community. And that's going to take your wealth to an even higher level than what Daisy is going to take you, which is going to be substantial. But it's just more and more and more now. And what I've learned in life is you don't want to stop. You don't want to take it for granted. You can slow down a little bit. You want to put yourself in more passive types of things. You want to invest in real estate. You want your money working for you because you're going to get tired eventually. As much as we think we'll never get tired, I mean, eventually, you know, doesn't matter. Even kings dream of other occupations. Everyone gets sick of what they're doing eventually. I don't care how great, you know, there's artists and actors and musicians that have risen to the top that have taken their lives. Everything gets old. You want to get your money working for you. But first, you must have enough of it. And Daisy is that bridge for that to happen for you. The system automates most of the heavy lifting. Matter of fact, it will automate 100% of everything, including the leads, including the texting, the sign-ups, everything. So it does that already. Put yourself in a financial position that is greater than you've ever experienced, that it's making you more money than you've made or ever could have made in those missed opportunities in the last 10 years combined, because that's happened with me. I've made more money with one opportunity than my entire life combined. Just one opportunity. And Daisy is that. That's going to happen for you guys. It's going to happen for me. I will make more money with Daisy than my entire, and I've made a lot of money my entire life combined. I wouldn't be doing this. I will hold out. I will collect welfare before I do the wrong thing. I will. Tons of stuff have come through. I've got to really believe in it. It's got to be big. It's got to be a future. Bigger than, you know, everything else that's out there. I learned that a long time ago. Pick the best thing, the number one. And Daisy is that. It can't be replicated. Daisy cannot be replicated. Even if someone comes up with a kind of like it, it can't be. It can't be replicated. Because you don't have the people that are running this thing, who are building the technology. So the website that you want to get started in is obviously amazy.ai. You want to go through there and you want to get started in the system. You want to get started now. You want to get ready for this week when they launch. Just learn the system. Start generating some leads. All you have to do is get the leads in. Get 100 leads in. Forget about the 24 signups. Get 100 leads. Get 100 leads locked into the system that when Daisy goes live, you can say, Daisy's live. Here's my link, and they sign up. And then you've got 30 days after that to work on them, 30 days, when they start seeing the results. 4 days, 53,000 people, $55 million came in 4 days. That's impressive. What's going to happen the first week they launch? Because it's been a month or two buildup. They didn't have that kind of buildup. I think they had like a month buildup or something. Now they've got 2 months more buildup of a proven system, 53,000 people, 55 million in revenue coming in 4 days, like, you know, like they've been doing updates every day and videos. Those cats are out every week doing videos. They're in it to win it. You can always tell. There's indicators. I always look for those indicators. You can tell. I can tell by the images they use what their intention is. I can look at a site and see an image and I say, I know what they're about. They're in it to win it. So this will, you know, 3 times, 100 times possibly more than what they've done that first 4 days. And all those leads that you've accumulated over the next day or two, 3 days, 4 days, well, there's your 24 because you've got 24, you've got 30 days to work on them. It's not going to be instant. Like, you're going to show people this and they're going to be like, oh, yeah, whatever. It's about timing. And it's about exposure, 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 exposure. Everyone says it. I don't care. Salesforce.com just did an excerpt article on it. Take 7 touches. That's Salesforce. Salesforce has the data. They're actually tracking all this shit. They have the best analytics in the world for sales conversions. And they did an article. I actually put it in the video. And they say it takes 7 touches before someone makes a sale. So it's not like, hey, you're going to share your link and people are just going to jump in. You got to hit them 7 times before that happens. It's timing. You can't replicate time. You're buying yourself time right now. The time that you say, well, I wish I would have did it then. No, timing's right now. And that's that. So I know I said what I wanted to do is I want to have some members. We usually don't do that. I did a company where you had the members come out all the time, and it's really effective. Matter of fact, I don't know if the company or the opportunity would have worked without people coming out like they did on the calls. It was like half presentation, half testimonial. So it is a powerful thing. It's just that we don't do it. We've never done it in the building of the system. Just here's the conversation, guys. I'm going to give it to you straight. We don't need to stroke you. We don't need to, you know, I think it's good to be excited, but you need to look at this logically. You don't need to be sold on this. You need to just look at this. Instead of joining something that's all hype, I see them all the time. It's just some hype video. Like, they don't even talk about anything. And people join them. It's like, holy shit. And I say, you know, I wonder why these work. And I say, it has to be because people don't want it to be real. They don't want it to be real. They want to continue to chase and then have a story that they never made it. They never got a break. Because that story sometimes feels good. Luckily, I was free of that story because I probably would have been telling that story myself. Poor kid on welfare, lost his parents, you know, never had a shot in the world, no education, was on welfare, eating free lunches in the park. Man, I can imagine my story would be at this point. Nothing would have went well for me. Luckily, I got involved in an environment that you couldn't tell a story like that. You started listening to the words they were saying, and it rubbed off on me. My mind started wiring differently. I started thinking differently. And I started earning money. My confidence went up. Now all the things that went on in the past, it's actually funny to say. I wouldn't change it. I'm proud of it. I'm excited about it. As a matter of fact, when I look at that, life as an adult is way harder than all that shit was. Life does not get easier. It gets harder. Next year will be twice as hard for you. The year after that will be twice as hard. And then if you don't have an opportunity like Daisy, I mean, what are you going to do? You're going to die telling that poverty shit story. Right now, like I said, if you want to know what path you're supposed to be on in life, look down. You're on it. You're here. Get out of your own way and just close your eyes and leap. Share your link, get 100 leads, and be done with it. And that's it. So I will open it up to members in the system. Hopefully they've got good things to say. I don't know. But it doesn't matter because 53,000 people said Daisy's a winner. That's all that matters. Cryptocurrency is the future. You know that. I don't need to sell you on that. I mean, you know that. Look at what's going on. Never happened before, and it will never happen again. Network marketing is great, but, I mean, come on. It's a lot of work. You want your money working for you. You want passive income. Eventually, you're going to burn out no matter what you're doing. Daisy provides that passive income, gets your money working for you, done by professionals. The ones that are doing it for enterprise organizations, trading organizations, I mean, you know, that's all you really need to know to make the decision logically. But maybe something someone shares tonight will excite you because I think that is a helpful little chemical to be released in the brain. So anyone that's currently involved in Amazie with Daisy here, you know, share kind of why, you know, your insight.
Yes, sir.
Could be your past, what you've done before, why you got started, what you see in Daisy, you know,
Doctor.
Anything that's happening for you. So *6, unmute your line. Who's here?
Hey, Don.
Who's
Garfield
this?
Garfield
here. Garfield. Hey, Garfield. What's up, man?
Oh, man, I'm so excited, Don. I'm so excited. Well, first of all, I want to say, you know, it's a great opportunity. And like you said, you know, I'm trying to get those 10 years back. And when my sponsor, I think she's on the line, Jacinta, she, you know, brought me to the opportunity and I saw what was going on. It was a no-brainer for me. I've tried all these different things. I'm doing this, just like you said earlier. You know, it's the same thing, just a different packaging. And when I saw it, at the time, I didn't have money. So I made some phone calls, and I made it happen because I said, I cannot miss this. You know, you have to be a fool to not see what's going on in the economy, for one, and for two, to know when you're in the beginning of something. And I actually just introduced her to the Amaze system because, I know you for a long time, since 2014. You know, I was in the ARP.
Yeah.
And I was actually me, the guy who comes and knocks on people's door at work and say, "Hi, it's Garfield. I'm here to fix your roof leak." I was on the leaderboard using this system, you know, and I couldn't believe it, you know. So I know the system works. Once I spoke to her and told her, "Listen, you have to run around and chase people and try to explain to them, oh, come over here. Look, the system does everything, does all the follow-up." It's like it's just a no-brainer, and I'm just so grateful and so excited, you know, about just getting the people, plugging them in, and the system does the rest. So you have a great opportunity, the best system there ever is. There's no way to fail. It's the only way to fail is to actually not take action. You know, so I'm just very excited.
Right.
And I'm just grateful to be here. And I'm just ready to rock, man. I'm just ready to rock.
Right on, man. Well, hey, Garfield, thank you so much for sharing that, man. Yeah, I mean, you know, you've been hanging around me for 2014. So, I mean, obviously, there's, something we're doing right here. But, yeah, thanks for coming out and sharing that, brother. Appreciate that. Appreciate you, dude.
All right.
Okay, who else? Star 6, unmute your line. Who else wants to share here tonight?
Hey, Don.
Hey, Don.
Yes. We're two at the same time.
Ladies first, eh?
Ladies first, that's right.
Ladies first, I got no problem.
All right,
thank
go
you.
Ahead,
hey,
who's
Don.
That?
This is Julie Barkley in Jacksonville, Florida.
Hey, Julie.
I just had to get on here and follow up with Garfield's gratitude. I have so much gratitude for you and how easy you're going to make this for so many people just because of what your ingenious tool, Quicklister, / what it's manifested into today. Everything in life is about timing, and it was an exciting tool back in the day when you used it for something we all worked together on. And I just feel so empowered knowing that you've already paved the way and we are in the right place at the right time for what Amaze and Daisy represent, so much to the point that I've gotten my 33-year-old son so excited, having watched his mother for years go after this nut. And as you already touched on, there were so many opportunities that they were just repackaged, never anything representative
yeah.
of the big one. And I think
yep.
we're all in the right place, right time, right place, and with your tool and the leadership, and we all make this happen, it is a no-brainer. We're all going to make a lot of money and live what it is that we were really looking for back 10 years ago. We can do this. I have every intention of doing it, and I'm going to lead my son the same direction his mother's going. I just needed to say that.
Right on. Well, thank you, Julie. Yeah, we go back, you know, quite a while with that opportunity that I was talking about where I borrowed the $1,500. I mean, and that's where Quicklister was born back then, to automate things. And, you know, this is a good point because it's kind of like you have to put in the time. And also, if you listen, like, guys, everyone on the line, like, once you've actually worked with someone, this is this industry. And I think this is the case in anything. Whatever industry, you've got to build that pipeline. You've got to build that association. And once you've made money, you know, you say a lot of people join these things. They say, "Well, I can't get anyone." Yeah, because you haven't made any money. Like, your goal is to get in and just make money. Because what ends up happening is once you've done that, no matter what you do after that, you're set for life. No matter what it is that I do afterwards, a group of people come because they know. It comes down to trust. It comes down to, you know, people want to go where, you know, they've had success prior. So they're going to come more likely with you. And that's what it's about. It's about building your network. So once you've actually made it here, you only have to make it once. It's not like you have to. It's not like a treadmill where you're running forever. A lot of things are like a treadmill. You're just running and running and running and forever. And you get tired. You get burnt out. And you don't really get anywhere. You're still in the treadmill. This, you know, an opportunity is an impact. It's a different thing. And the right opportunity makes you money rapidly. It makes everyone else rapidly. Like, the good opportunities make everybody money. it's not just, you know, me. It's the right opportunity makes money for everybody. It isn't someone that is substantial, because I wasn't. I failed at everything else, didn't make money in network marketing and other businesses, but yeah, I found the right opportunity. I made money and everyone else made money. That's what you got to look out for. You have to look where the ground is fertile. Daisy, 53,000 people, like, that's how you know there's signs to it. There's red flags and there's green flags. And you have to be looking out for those, especially once you've made money in something. You know what to look for. There's no longer, I hope this will make money. Like, you actually know what to look for. So thank you for sharing, you know, with that, you know, Julie. Appreciate that very much.
Thanks, Don.
All right. So who else do we have? Who was that? Who else was there? Who's going to jump out?
Yeah, Don, it's me, Jose from Jersey.
Jose from Jersey. What's up, man?
How you been, brother?
Good.
Good, man. Everything you said was on point, man. I've made money with your system before. I know it works. To me, it's the greatest marketing platform I've ever seen in my life. To this day, I still say the best platform ever on the planet as far as capturing leads and getting the presentation and opting in with cell phones. I mean, there's nothing like it. Anyways, what I had a question for you about the opportunity. Let's say, for instance, 30 days a company launches, and I, at the end of the 30 days, I get, let's say, 20 people that came in, buyers. They came in the opportunity. I got 20. I didn't make my 24. What happens? Do I lose that opportunity, or does it extend, or do I? Or there's
no
limit.
You lose it. You lose it. But here's the thing.
Okay.
It's 24.
Mm-hmm.
This is what you got to shoot for.
Right.
You want to? I mean, this is. I mean, it's so. Here's the thing. Here's the formula. 153,000 people said yes. In four days. It's not like over time. They need to prove themselves. I mean, basically, they've got nothing. No one knew who these people were. I didn't. I watched a video and I said yes that night. Not only did I say yes to the opportunity, but I invested a month of my life building a system after just spending a month building another one that was going to sell our software for the new platform, and I dropped that bitch like a potato. I said, this is once in a lifetime. You know what I mean? Like,
right on.
Right? So, you know, there's all the elements. I'm going to get your money working for you. So now I've always said, I wish I could have another one that worked as hard as me. Well, nothing's going to work harder than my money or anyone's money. It will work way harder than you, especially if it's smart money put in smart hands like we have with Daisy. Not only that, man, but we got the system, which I mean, we're the lead generation, I think, masters of the planet. We've always been. I mean, we've launched things. We do 200 million, 30 million. Like virtually faster than any company. No company has broke our records when it comes to that. Automated, right? But the thing is this. This is the guarantee. Forget about 24. Get 50. Get 50. You know what I mean? Like 24? No.
Yeah.
50
yeah.
in 30 days, guys. 50 people referred in 30 days. 24 is the minimum, but I'm not going to risk getting 24 people and stopping. Yeah, I'm getting 50. And I don't have to get 50. I just have to get 500 leads. That's it. I'm not thinking about 50. I'm thinking about 500 leads, which I've already got. And that's how you do it. Because the leads will drop in because you've got 30 days to drip on those people. 1,000 leads. That's the number you're going for. Not signups, leads. Because they're mobile opt-ins. They're dripping on them. Everyone here, you guys, how have you been loving the autoresponders? I watched some of you having a conversation with them. Like you're actually talking to someone. Don't even know. Some of you do because you're familiar with the autoresponders. And you can say, this is a message, auto message. And then I step in. I've had conversations with a lot of you myself. I mean, it's not just you. I'm here helping. We're all partners in this. We're going to show this company some numbers. You know, Daisy's just going to explode out of nowhere. Well, we're going to explode out of nowhere. They're going to be well aware of us and who we are very soon because we're generating a lot of leads and we're going to bring a lot of business to Daisy. And so that's what you have to focus on, everyone. So I'm so glad you mentioned that, Jose, is that you just focus on the leads. They'll drop in. Auto messages, they're going to see Daisy's going to do an announcement. We just crossed 100 million. We just crossed 1 million reps. And then you hit that tipping point, and then it doubled. One of the things about I've noticed in systems is the numbers doubles. It goes from 100 to 500 to 1,000, 2,000, 5,000, 10,000. I mean, the numbers really start compounding. That's what it does. So Daisy will start compounding. Once they hit 1 million, it's going to start doubling. It won't take that long to get to 1 million. It'll take a half the time or a quarter of the time. It starts taking less time to double that number. And you are in first. You are prepared. You'll be the, you know, the guru. You'll be the expert. Because you got in and you prepared before everyone else did. They weren't even, they're not even on the path yet. They're further back on the path. They haven't got to that big oak tree yet that we're all at. They're still working through the brush. We're at the oak tree. They haven't even caught up yet. So when they do catch up to the oak tree, to this opportunity called Daisy, you'll already be at that point and you've already arrived. You've already made your money. It wouldn't even matter what the next million does. You're already done. You're already at that financial place where you're set. You've made up for the last 10 years because that's the kind of money we're talking about with this. Or I wouldn't be doing it. It's going to be big or I'd rather collect welfare. So thank you, Jose, for sharing that, man. I appreciate that.
Right,
that's
on,
what you got to focus on, just the leads. Get 50, not 24. Guarantee your position. Don't gamble with that shit. Guarantee it. Just focus on the leads, 500 leads. Want to even double up on that? 1,000 leads. Do whatever it takes. Get 1,000 opt-ins. Mobile opt-ins, not emails. No one can sign up onto everyone. It's keep what you capture. Once they've opted into your Daisy page, they can't sign up. I've had people come to me and say, hey, my brother just opted in. My brother. This has happened, for a decade. You know, my best friend, they opted into such and such's page. Can you move them? Answer's always the same. No. You're just going to have to, like, deal with it. We don't move people. Once they've opted into someone's page, that's it. They're locked in because the brother opted in first, and then that person got started and then tried to hit up their brother, and the brother was already opted in to someone else's page months ago. And when they sent them the link, hey, check this out, when they opted in to look at the offer, it was locked to someone else. We don't move people. So all the leads that you're generating now are locked to you, ensuring that they sign up in Daisy with you, no one else. And I watch out for that. No one gets the sidestep here. We monitor. I've removed big names from the system. I call it cannibalism. It's not allowed here. I don't care how much contribution or how much success they're bringing our system. I've removed two big people. Two of the biggest people online hate my guts because of that. Big names, and it sucks. But, hey, integrity first. I'm a person of principle. It's not happening. Not my system. It's not. This is my house. This is the way we operate.
Yeah, right on, man.
I'm no sellout. So,
right on. I love it.
Yeah. Right on. All right. Who's next?
Hey, Don, it's Kevin.
Hey, Kevin.
Hey, speaking of which, in the funnel, I'm already in Daisy and I already have my link. Is there a way we can put our link within the funnel, or do we have to send them that directly after they opt in?
Well, what's going to happen here is once Daisy goes live in the next couple of days, we're just going to text out your link to all your leads with the instruction video on them getting started. Once everyone kind of has their links, then there'll be a spot underneath funnels where you'll put your Daisy link in there and save it. Then it's automatically put in the funnel. So the steps will be a little different. But right now, you know, people can just get started in the system. So they watch the presentation, they put in their PIN, then they go to the next video, which is, hey, sign up for the system and begin building your list. And then they can join the system. Well, once Daisy goes live, they will not be able to join the system until they verify that they've joined Daisy. So they won't even see that video to get started in the system. That's an opportunity only for now. You must join Daisy. You must confirm your link that you've joined Daisy into the system. Then it'll unlock the next video. So that then they can then get in the system and start sharing it and building a team. So that will be automatic, completely automated all the way through. They'll get the video on how to set up Daisy, how to get started. They'll actually get started with Daisy, confirm their link, and then they can get started in the system. Right now, people can just get started in the system before that happens.
Okay.
All right?
All right. Thanks, man.
You got it, man. Cool. Who else?
Hey, John, it's Frank.
I'm sure everyone's like, you know, what do you mean? We're going to come on the call. We've never done this. Anyway, Frank, what's up, man?
Yeah, you know, I've only been with you for a month and a half, but I've been blown away at the amount of effort that you put in behind my back, helping me close my own leads.
Right on.
The conversations that keep going on that I don't even know about till I turn on my computer in the morning and I see that you've already sent them two messages. And I just wanted to mention that because I really appreciate that.
Yeah, well, you've got it, man. And I appreciate you sharing that. You know, one of the things I think a system does is it's leverage. If I have found, not just is it better for me psychologically, because I have to believe in something. I think we all are like that. We've got to believe in it before we do it. It's like, because it excites us. I want to feel excited. I want to feel excited all the time. And money doesn't excite me. It never has. Just never has. Other people having success is what my driving force is. So I have to know that. Know thyself. So I'm going to always put in the extra effort to help you guys make money so that I feel good. I feel excited because I want to feel excited each and every day. And also the second part of that is that the more money you guys make, the easier it is for everybody to promote this. People will gravitate to where the money is. Doesn't matter what it is. Doesn't matter what it is. People will gravitate towards the money. And so the more money that people make in the system, I don't know if you've seen one of the videos, we have people make $1 million in commissions within 12 months in our system their first year. I mean, you know, that's a powerful message. Third party, someone hearing that makes the sales for everybody much easier. So that's always been our focus is duplication. Because in this industry, without duplication, well, you might as well be selling fax machines and burning, you know, your life away one at a time. It's duplication that actually creates the success in this industry. And so anything we can do above and beyond the automation that we have and the auto messages that we have, if I'm going to step in there, you know, it's because of that reason, duplication. That's that.
Well, I appreciate it.
Yeah. Well, thanks, Frank.
Yeah, question.
Yes.
How do we go about joining Daisy from this point?
Great question. So as soon as Daisy goes live, well, as soon as we get the word, which is going to give us a 24-hour window. So that's the great thing is that we'll have a 24-hour window that gives everybody kind of a little bit of breathing room. So it's like, hey, we're live. We're ready to go. But they're giving us 24 hours on top of that to kind of get everything situated and ready. So what will happen is that you'll get your link. If you don't have it already, then you'll get your link so you can actually go join Daisy. Yeah, you said you don't have it, right? So you'll get a link so you can actually go join Daisy and everyone else. I mean, all my people, because when I came in that next morning, Daisy, you know, went offline. So my whole group of people, same thing. They're all going to be waiting for their link. So everyone's going to wait for their link. They'll all get their link. They'll go sign up in order. Because it will go out in the tech. All my people will get a link from me. You'll get your link to sign up from the person that referred you in the system. And then you go sign up.
I don't know who that is.
Well, it's in your back office. So if you go to your dashboard and there's a little clickable little fidget thing there. And that fidget thing is called sponsors or partners. Yeah, partners, my partners. So if you click on my partners, it's on the right-hand side next to the surfboard.
Okay.
Whoever that person is, yeah, is your sponsor.
Okay.
Yep.
All right. Thanks.
You're welcome. Thanks, Frank.
Hi, I'm Teresa. I'm calling you out of California. Are you there?
Teresa?
Hello. Hi. So I have a question. I still have not been able to log in. Is there any way you can send me a link so I can get into it?
So let me ask you a question. So what part are you – so this is this is the best way to go through this. So go to amazee.ai, so A-M-A-I-Z-E.ai. So little link there at the bottom that says returning visitor, or you can just opt in again. It doesn't matter. I mean, you just opt in, but if you know your PIN, then you can put your PIN, your phone number, your PIN, it'll take you to where you left off. But if you opt in just straight again, it'll take you to a page like the application page, but there'll be a continue button. So you just keep clicking continue till you get to the final page, which has the presentation. The presentation PIN is 1212. If it did lock up again because you haven't gone in it, it might have, you know, required the PIN again. So you just put 1212 underneath that presentation video. That'll unlock the rest of the page. The video, which is the system video, is the code for that is 1515. That'll unlock the join form, and then you join there. Now, if it already shows that it's joined, I don't think that it has. If I would have remembered you, then you just text, say, hey, the number you got the PIN from or any text message you've received in the system, you can just respond to that message and you'll be, you know, get instructions on where you actually go and log into the main site, which is QuickLister. But that's the way you're going to want to come through. You're going to want to go through Amazee, keep clicking continue till you come to the join form, do the join, and then you'll get a login to the site from there.
Okay, perfect. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
And thank you for the opportunity, too. I appreciate it.
You got it.
John, hello?
Yes.
Hi, this is Clara. I have a couple questions.
What's your name?
My name's Carol.
Hi, Carol.
Tara, that's okay.
Tara. My cousin's name is Tara, actually. Caroline.
Oh, well. Small world. So I joined Daisy, like, in January, you know, when it, like, first won.
Mm-hmm.
And then it went offline, and then, like, I was just waiting for all the updates. So then, I was also unable to get on to the site. I got on, like, once, and then that was it.
Yeah.
I wanted to ask you, are there
Daisy's not going back online because they actually launched and they had to rebuild all their smart contracts because too many people all at once. Usually, you know, the worst nightmare for a new system is too many people. We crashed. We were taken out for a long time because of that reason, because things fell. That's it. So Daisy brought in 53,000 people. That created a little too much. And, you know, usually you can buy time. You can scale. Every startup, you know, they do what's called, you know, this, you know, minimal viable product. And then once it gets a certain point, you build it. You have to build it in stages to handle the growth. But if it happens overnight like that, like which happened with Daisy, you're screwed. And that's what happened. So now they went offline for the last month plus, however long, to rebuild those contracts, which they now have, you know, completed. They've gone through the testing, and they're going to be relaunching again in the next couple of days. So at that point, you'll be able to then go to Daisy, the site, and actually log into your account and start building from there.
Okay, and what are the packages that you will have available or for?
So you're talking about the marketing system?
Yeah.
The referral system?
Yeah.
Okay, so what you're going to want to do is you want to go through amazee.ai.
Okay.
Because if you're on this call, you've already opted into that already. So you're locked to whoever referred you already.
Right.
No,
I paid $100.
That's Daisy. That's different. So you already purchased the first level package with Daisy. Okay. So this is the marketing system. This is Amazee. This is not connected to Daisy. All we're doing is building, well, at this point, pre-building a team to get started in Daisy once it goes live.
Right.
So that's the marketing system. And that is amazie.ai. AMAIZE.AI. Just go in as returning visitor or just opt in again, like I went over with Teresa a moment ago, and then go through and you can sign up in the system. It'll walk through, you know, there's obviously the Daisy video, which you've probably watched already, the new one. Watch it again. It's always, I do. I watch the stuff. It fires you up, right? Also, you learn, it's like reading a book. You always get something new when you read the book a second time. Yeah, if you haven't clicked, this hasn't clicked for you guys, go watch the video again. Like, you have to see it. You have to kind of, the mind needs to see things several times. That's why Salesforce, 7 touches, because people aren't paying attention. Eventually, once they pay attention, they're like, oh, my God. One of my favorite movies, I remember, I walked out of the movie theater. I said, now it's my favorite movie. I've watched it like 100 times. Like, sometimes, you know, we're like, But once you see it, you're like, oh, my God, I love this. So watch the video again, and then you can put the code in, go to the next video, watch the system video, and then you can get started in the system and start promoting Daisy. So when Daisy goes live again, you've got some referrals. Have you referred anyone in Daisy yet? Probably not, right?
Because
you just got started and it went offline,
one
right?
Person? Yeah.
Oh, congratulations. That's good.
Yeah,
okay. So here you'll be able to start referring people until, you know, at least until they launch, you get some people in. But it can happen rapidly. There's people come in here and they'll generate 100, 200 leads the first day. I mean, it doesn't take that much to generate a couple hundred leads.
Oh, my God.
it doesn't. So, I mean, you can pretty much ensure you hit that 24 referrals, that Pacesetter bonus, by just getting the leads. It's going to come down to the leads.
So
I mean, they're not
going to
opt in if they're not looking for an opportunity. You know, no one opts into an opportunity video unless they're looking for an opportunity. That's it. And they're just looking for the right one. And it's never really about what they can afford. It's just about they need to know they're going to win. And that happens from exposure and the right information, the right story, the right something. Everyone has their thing that gets them. Could be a friend that gets in. They're like, oh, my God, that happens all the time. So that's all you got to do. Is that clear? Go through amazie.ai, go through, and then you get started in the system. And then just pay attention, because as soon as Daisy does relaunch, you'll know, because we'll let you know that happened. That's it.
Okay, great. Thank you so much.
Well, you are very welcome. Okay, guys, anyone else looking to share?
Hey, Don, how you doing?
Who's this?
This is Rob from Maine.
Hey, Rob.
How you doing? Hey, I've been with Quick Lister since probably 2014, 2015, somewhere around there. But is there someone I can reach out for some technical support tomorrow?
Go to support inside the system.
Yeah.
And do that. Or you can just text in to the number and just say, hey.
The number, okay.
Yeah, the number. Just say, hey, Don, reach out to me. I'll give you a call.
Okay.
Whatever you need.
Yeah, I want to get this set up and ready to roll.
Right on, man. All right.
Yeah, I love it. It's a great system. The thing rocks.
Good deal, dude.
All right. Thank you very much.
Hey,
talk to you tomorrow.
All right, dude.
Bye. Hey, Don. Chris in Ohio.
Who's that in Ohio?
Chris in Ohio,
Ken,
buddy.
How's it going?
Right, we'll go Chris, and then we'll go to the next one.
Hey, Don. Yeah, I was wondering,
about ready.
You recommend doing the Clever wallet then, or can you do any wallets that carries Tron?
So I just loaded up 3 new videos because, you know, Daisy is going to the USDT coin, which is better, a stable coin that's locked to the dollar. So the numbers, it can't fluctuate. Okay, so I put up 3 videos for that, but it's also a video if you log into the back office, there's a video there. It's like the 4th one in now. So there's 4 wallet setup videos that I have there. 3 are for converting for different things, but the main one is showing you should use Clever and TronLink. Because Clever is where you would buy crypto, but you could use Coinbase. You could go to CoinMama. You could buy Bitcoin anywhere, and then you can just convert it from any platform as well. Well, Clever is where I've been converting. I like Clever.
Yeah.
The video
I
that I have.
Yeah, I don't think. Yeah, go ahead.
What's that?
I was going to say, I don't think Coinbase carries Tron, though.
No, no. You got to. So what I recommend is buying it through Clever. Using the Clever, that's what I'm using. I got my phone, I've got Clever on there, and I've got Tron Link, and that's about all I'm going right now, those two apps. And, yeah, I just did a bunch of – I did the videos today, so I went in there and I did the whole conversion, the swap. I did the swap from Tron to USDT, and I did that video and I loaded it up. But it was pretty simple to do, but there's a video now for it. But, yeah, I would use Clever to buy, then move it to Tron, then you switch it from – then you can convert it, which the video I loaded up today shows you how to do that, to convert it from Tron to USDT, and then you just send it to your Tron, your USDT wallet that you'll have in Tron Link. So, yeah, okay. So those videos, watch those videos I put up there today.
All right, buddy. And I got some money in Coinbase. I got some Bitcoin. Can I transfer that into Clever?
Yes, yeah. That's what I did. I started pulling out. I had all these little kind of wallets with amounts everywhere, and I dumped them all into Clever. I just went into all my accounts. I created an address, I got my Bitcoin wallet address in Clever. And here's the thing with this. Always do a test. So send $10. Make sure you do it right. Once you do it right the first time, you can save the address in Clever, and then you'll be able to just copy that ad. Well, all you would have to do in Clever is go to Bitcoin and go to the little button that says receive. So there's no messing that up. If you go to receive, that's going to be your address, no ifs, ands, or buts about it. And there's a little box that says, a little button that says copy address. And then you go to Coinbase and you send to that address and it will send over.
Okay, buddy. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
I'll go ahead.
But still only do $10 just so it's a confidence thing.
Right.
You'll tend
right,
to, you, it, yeah, I, even me, like if I'm sending big amounts, even if it's like a website, when I'm going to go text a website, even though it's my website, I've sent it out 1,000 times. I copy and I paste it into a browser. I hit go, and I make sure the page loads. It's just habit for me because there's nothing going to ruin my day more than making a mistake. And, you know, so sometimes if I'm too busy and I'm not focused, you can do that, right? You're not paying attention. So I will always test. Send yourself $10 from Coinbase to your wallet. It shows up in your Clever wallet. Now you got confidence. You say, this is my address. This is how it works. Now go dump the rest.
Right.
So this way, you tend to procrastinate on doing that because you don't want to mess it up. You know, it's scary.
Right. And then we'll wait for our link from our upline that they have from Daisy or from Daisy. Then,
yeah.
And we'll wait for that link. Okay.
Yep. Yep. Just chill, pump leads, and just wait for that link. That's it.
Oh. All right. Great. Thank you. Will they put that in our back office? Will that go in our back office?
The link that you're going to be signing up from your partner. Will be texted to you initially.
Okay.
Yeah, it'll be texted through the system to you, your partner's link, once they actually have signed up themselves. So you might, you know, just chill. And everyone here, I mean, you know, you got to chill. You have to wait until you get your link. Then once, you know, from your partner, then you go sign up on Daisy. It's really quick. 5 minutes, you're done. And then you got your link. It's right at the bottom. There's a nice button that says click here to get your link. You copy your link. And then you send it to yourself, do a test, you know, send it to yourself. I use Skype in my phone. So I'll text myself, and then I got Skype on my phone, and I'll text it in Skype, copy and paste it in Skype, and then I'll go to Skype and I'll go on my computer. So this way I can be on two different devices, and I always like test something like that, like a Bitcoin wallet where people are going to send me payment. Like, I'm testing that shit. And then also, like, if I'm going to give an opportunity link, you best be sure that I'm actually going to test it from a different device that when I'll even use, like, the Google – on Google Chrome, they have that incognito. Like, I'll use that as a way of making sure it's not connected to me and making sure that my shit shows up on that page. And then that's the link I'm going to send the people because, you know, I don't want to make a mistake, you know. Send that link out to everyone, you know?
Right.
So always test, yeah.
Would it make sense to go incognito and then even go maybe DuckDuckGo or something like that even?
No, DuckDuckGo sucks.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Just use incognito.
No, so
or use, you know what's a good browser? Opera. Opera has VPN built right in for free, by the way, guys, for free.
Didn't know that.
Opera. Yep. You just download it to your desktop and bang. It doesn't do it on the phone. They don't have it on the VPN on the phone one, but the computer desktop one, Opera, is right there. You just put VPN, whatever country, it's free just by downloading the browser.
Oh, good to know. Thanks, bud.
Yep, you got it.
I don't have a question. I just wanted to thank you and everybody else and just how positive people have been in general. Just with everything going on, wanting to help the next person, that's probably the biggest aspect that I've seen out of this. And I'm very grateful just to be around y'all. So
right on. Well, thanks, man. I appreciate that. Thanks for being here.
You bet. You guys have a good night, all right?
You too, dude. Okay, who else has a question or wants to share something?
No, Dan, I just want to say thank you for everything, Dan. This is Ahmed from Boston.
Hey, Ahmed.
Thank you, buddy. I'm just giving out the last text message, the one that you were sending, the link, the one says 519. And I'm giving it to people. So are those people, if they sign in, they're going to be routing to me, right?
That's correct.
Okay.
What do you mean your link? Your link under your lightning bolt?
The text message that you sent me, remember the last time? The text
message. Yes.
I've been forwarding the text message for the conference call. My friends, they were listening to it.
You can give the conference call. We're going to have, this call, is always recorded, but don't do recorded calls too much, but this will be available. Yeah.
But this is good, man. Thanks a lot for everything. We just have to go get people.
That's it.
I just want to say thank you so much for letting me be part of it, Dan. Thank you.
Thanks for being here, Amit. So that's it, guys.
Man.
So anyone that's here, obviously, you know what to do. Go to Maisie.ai, go back to the system, get started. Start pre-building your team. It really just comes down to how many leads you're generating. 24 people get you into the Pacesetter bonus, which means that you're getting 1.8% of a $500 million fund. That's all you have to focus on. And if you hit it, you're set. If you don't hit it, well, it's because you didn't try. And that's all it really comes down to. That's all that can get in your way with something like this. And the ground's fertile. People are going to like this. They already have proven that. And I don't really know what else you could possibly do after this that would be any less work. If you really think about it, what could be any less work, right, than this? Even if you were selling, water to people doing a marathon, half those people still wouldn't take the water because they're running. But you get my point. You want to be selling something that's popular, and this is popular. No matter what you're going to be doing, you're going to be selling something on something. That's it. Nothing happens until something is sold. Van Gogh died broke. He didn't sell his first painting until after he died. Now, you can Google it. One of his paintings sold for $80 million. I don't care if you're a painter. I don't care what you're doing. You're not making any money until something is sold. Or you're working for somebody who is. It's the only way to make money in life. You either are selling something, investing into something, or you are working for someone who is. There's no other way. Giving blood. But someone's selling that to somebody. There's even that. There's nothing you could do on the planet that makes money other than selling something or investing into something that ultimately is selling something. Or you're working for someone who is. There's no other way. So you want to sell the thing that's the most popular. At the same time, if you can invest from the money that you're making from the selling of something, that's even better. So now there's two entities making money. And then you've got a system here and you've got support to do it. So unless you're not going to do anything, then, which is fine too. Nothing wrong with doing nothing. Just accept it. There's no suffering in that. but if you don't accept it, there's a ton of suffering. So choose one. You can take action on that. And that's it. So it was my pleasure to be here with you guys tonight. I'll see you all again real soon, I'm sure. And with that, you guys have a fantastic rest of your evening, and I'll see you all soon. Good night, everyone.
Thank you.
Bye for now.
Good night.